Hello beauties! Welcome to my channel. I hope you are all doing good. My name is Brooke. Konnichiwa, Brooke desu. So I've been making this body type videos on my TikTok account and I basically talk about styling tips for each body type. So if you're interested, go follow me on TikTok. And I always wanted to make that how to find your body type video. So this will be the video today. Since I don't want to like tell any misunderstanding information, I wrote it down on my laptop. So I'll be looking at my laptop. I want to make this video very useful so you could come back if you are having trouble identifying your body type. Like I said before, this video is gonna be how to find your body type. So if you are interested in like tips for your body type, let me know in the comment section so I can make a separate video explaining about styling tips for each body types. So yeah, let me know. By the way, sorry if I keep looking down. I just have all my memos over here on my laptop, so I'll kind of be just like looking up and down. Now let's talk about body types. So body type is just a guided tool that you could use. It's not like a rule book that you have to follow. Knowing your body type could help you in so many ways, including creating outfits for yourself and styling for your body and even shopping for your outfits since you know what will best suit you. It doesn't matter if you're petite, if you're tall, if you're curvy, if you're skinny, it really doesn't matter. It's just determining your shape. Before we do get into details, I just want to quickly say that every body is beautiful. I don't want people to feel like, oh, I have this body type and I'm insecure about this body type. No, like every body is beautiful. If you are uncertain of what body type you have, please keep watching this video so I could explain it, how to find out your body type with and without measurements. Overall, there are 5 different body types. Now people might say there are more, but I just wanted to keep it simple and easy, so I'm just gonna go by these 5 body types. And keep in mind, I will mention this again later on, but you could actually be combined with different body types. I will be using myself as an example for this video, but I have both rectangular and triangle body type, so just keep that in mind. I'll be going over the without doing the measurements, so you won't have to do all the math and stuff like that. Yeah. And it's the easiest way. So there's a lot of names out there for like each body type. Some will describe it as a fruit, some will describe it as a shape, some will describe it as an alphabet, but I didn't want to go through every name out there, so I'm just gonna keep it simple and go by shape, and you see what I mean in a bit. In no particular order, like I said, there are 5 different body types. So the first one is called the rectangular body type. So for this body type, your bust, your waist, your hips are gonna be about the same measurement, and you also won't be having a lot of waist definition, so you're pretty much proportionate and straight. The second body type is called the triangle body type. For this body type, your hips will be larger than your bust. The third body type is called the inverted triangle body type, and this body type is opposite from the triangle, so your bust will be larger than your hips. The fourth body type is called the circle body type. For this body type, your waist measurement will be the largest, so your stomach will be the widest part of your body. So the fifth body type is called the hourglass body type. And for this body type, your bust and your hips are going to be about the same measurement, and you'll have a waist definition as well. Okay, so now that we know all the different body types, which body type are you? That's your question. Yes. So I'll tell you how to find it without measurement first. You could do this by just having a mirror in your body. So what you do is basically stand in front of the mirror and see where the widest part of your body is. Preferably if you can be naked, or if you can't do that, just wear something that is fitted. So like leggings or like a sports bra or something like that. So when you're looking yourself in the mirror, if you're not sure where the widest part is, imagine this like straight line from your bust to your hips and see what will stuck out the most. Doing that will just identify where the widest part for your body can be. And for triangle body types, for example, it will be the hips that's gonna be the widest. For inverted triangles, it will be the bust that will be the largest. And for circle body types, it will be the waist that will be the largest. And for hourglass body types, now for here, you have to determine if your bust and your hips are about the same or exactly the same. If you feel like your bust and your hips are about the same size, then you could have an hourglass body type. And if you feel like you can't really determine where the widest part of your body is, you most likely have a rectangular body type since you are proportionate from your bust to your hips. So if you're still unsure about what body type you have and you want to get like accurate numbers and everything, here are some ways you could do that. And I understand, because some people like me, if you have combined body types, you might be like, okay, so am I this one or this one? So measuring might help you determine your body type for sure. So what you're going to do for both of the methods I'm going to mention is measure your bust, measure your waist, waist and your hips. And you're going to write that number down, and then you're going to compare the number. And so I'll go over each and every body type so you could get an understanding. The first one, we're going to go over rectangular body type. So for this body type, like I said before, your measurement will be about the same. So your bust, your hips, your waist are going to be about the same measurement. You're going to take one of the numbers and subtract your waist number. So if the difference is less than, I'll say about 7 or 8 inches, so less than those numbers, you'll have a rectangular body type since it is showing that you don't really have a waist definition. So if you're an opposite where your bust and your hips are about the same number and you subtract your waist number, and if it's going to be bigger than, I'll say 7-8 inches and more, you could have an hourglass body type since you are a body type with waist definition. Just keep in mind that for hourglass and rectangular body types, your bust and your hips are going to be about the same measurement. For triangle body types, if your hips are larger than your bust by 4 inches or more, you have a triangle body type. For opposite inverted triangle body types, if your bust is larger than your hips by 4 inches or more, you'll have an inverted triangle body type. And if your measurement for your waist is larger than your bust or hips by 2 inches or more, you have a circle body type. Since I have a rectangular and triangle body type, this is how my measurement will be. So quickly going over my body, my bust is 32 inches, and my waist is about 26 right now, and my hips are going to be 36 inches. If I subtract my hips to my bust, I have 4 inch of a difference, so that will put me in triangle body type. If I subtract my bust, 32 minus 26 is 6 inches. So that's how I can determine that I am a rectangular and a triangle body type.
Lastly, I wanted to share this information over here. It goes by percentage instead of numbers, and it is a similar way, but you could pause the video and compare them this way as well.
I hope this was helpful, and if you have any questions, please let me know. You could comment in the description. You could comment in the comment section. If you have any video suggestions, like I said, if you want to know about like styling tips for different body types, please let me know. I can make a video. Hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your day, and I hope to see you soon. Bye!